Mental Health Research Institute in Parkville also administers the Cunningham Dax collection of psychiatric art. This art is used by various drug companies and also by the Royal Australian College of Psychiatrists to advertise drugs for the treatment of psychiatric problems and also to teach students in medicine, nursing, psychology, and the other health sciences about how to diagnose mentally ill people. The drug company Pfizer is one of the major drug companies that have used the art from the Dax collection. Eric Cunningham Dax was the psychiatrist who oversaw the development and expansion of the psychiatric industry in Melbourne and Victoria in the 1950s and 1960s. You can see from the 5-year income and expenditure summary that the income of the Mental Health Research Institute increased dramatically during this period. The molecular schizophrenia division is involved in developing drugs that target dopamine receptors and also serotonin receptors. Is the neurotransmitter that is targeted by the SSRI drugs and also by a range of new antipsychotic drugs, including risperidone produced by Janssen-Cilag. The Mental Health Research Institute are also involved in developing post-mortem diagnosis after people have died of various mental problems. The use of music, art, and other non-drug approaches in the treatment of psychological problems is not investigated at all by the Mental Health Research Institute. The Mental Health Research Institute have also put forward or promoted the idea that attention deficit hyperactivity disorder is also a genetic problem. And they argue that ADHD is again related to abnormal dopamine metabolism. This justifies the use of dopamine receptor stimulating drugs such as Ritalin and dexamphetamine for the treatment of ADHD. The labeling of ADHD has become a matter of common concern because a number of children who display normal behavior but refuse to obey their teachers or their parents are being labeled with this condition and started on to stimulant drugs as early as 2 or 3 years of age. David Kopolov, in his director's report, points to the World Health Organization's prediction that mental problems are set to increase throughout the world over the next 20 years.